Hello, YouTube. It's the spaceman landing in your area once again. I'm back after about a week, and I've got a big pipe and tobacco yabo for you. So stay tuned. I'll be right back. I'm back after about a week of absence, and I'm smoking my Missouri Meerschaum Bent Original with the beautiful orange stem. And tonight I'm trying a Missouri Meerschaum blend of tobacco. It's a pouch blend, and it's called Great Dane. A good portion of this tobacco is gently steamed Black Cavendish, select Virginias, and some white Burley. Now, this is a mixture cut or mixed cut. I'm going to let you have a look at it. It's been topped with a smooth and rich combination of a rich dark cherry with some warm notes of vanilla and caramel. Oh man, does it smell good. It is a wonderfully delicious cherry vanilla aroma from the pouch. Fine pouch aroma there. On the pouch, it lists it as a deep sweet Cavendish blend with notes of dark cherry and fragrant vanilla. Now, I've smoked this blend already, and it smokes very good. It burns down to a fine ash all the way down to the bowl. It's consistent in flavor all the way down. It's lightly sweet. It has a cherry vanilla flavor, but it does not have the sharp maraschino type cherry flavor that a lot of cherries do. So it's a blend that I would highly recommend you trying. I was a little hesitant at first to try the Missouri Meerschaum pouch blends, but turns out they're great tobaccos. And they have it has an amazing room aroma or room note. So without further ado, I've got some packages. I'm a little backed up here. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4 boxes to open for you. Now, the first one is the big one. We'll start with that right first, right? And this is from Pipes and Cigars. So let's go ahead and get this baby open. I know I've got some pouched blends in here. Or what they often refer to, of course, you know, as OTC, over-the-counter. I don't know that many tobacco shops actually carry the Missouri Meerschaum blends. But I can tell you that I'm having quite a good experience with this one. So it's kind of caught me off guard there a little bit. Now, this Yabo is a particularly big Yabo. And by the way, I also have a pipe. And I'm going to save that for last. So we're going to go first with this. This is just a Missouri Meerschaum hat that I've ordered. So I'm just going to go ahead and just put that on for the rest of the video. How's that? Okay? So let's see what we got here. We got some tins. I've got 3 Hearth and Home Black House, which is an awesome blend, and they just restocked. Replenish their stockpile, so I decided to go ahead and just order me a little bit of that to sell her, because it's one of my favorite blends. And I'm gonna go next with this. Oh, that is good. This is Lane Very Cherry Pipe Tobacco. Now, I have this blend, but what we got here is something that I ordered called Free For All. It's 3 cherry blends. I thought, originally I was under the impression that they had blended these 3 together in one blend and called it the Free For All, but I guess they give you all 3 blends. Peter Stockaby 3 cherry pipe tobacco. And where's the other one? I guess that's it. Okay, I guess that's it. I don't see. So this is the Free For All, and I'm just thinking that you would blend these 2 together and make your cherry pipe tobacco that way. I also ordered some Captain Black Royal, which I'm surprised it didn't come in the regular pouch. I don't know why. I really did want it in the pouch. I guess they ran out of that. And some Captain Black Cherry. I want a little nuts with the cherry here, right? Let's see what else I got here. Okay. This was... these 2 blends here are pouch blends. Borkum Riff Black Cavendish and Captain Black Dark. They were part of a set, a duo called Black Knight. So, be giving them a try soon. Sooner than later. And I ordered a pipe tobacco that I've actually have never tried to this day. And that is this, Carter Hall. I see a lot of people smoking this on YouTube. I see Cane Rod Piper talking about it a lot, and I'm thinking it's probably it's got to be really good. If he gives it a good recommendation, it's got to be good. Okay. Here's a little one-off thing here. It's a pipe cork knocker for my ashtray. Actually, already have one, but it's kind of wearing out in one of my ashtrays, so I got that. I'll relight my pipe here. Excuse me while I relight. By the way, I got a new Zippo. I like that one. I think it's really beautiful. It's got the brown and the little pipe shape on it. And I got a pouch of this, Sir Walter Raleigh. The first time I've ever had that. Classic burley smoking tobacco. From what I understand, it has like a nutty, chocolatey kind of flavor to it. So, boy, we got a lot of OTC blends here. And try and nose out. I think what I'm going to do is just go ahead and put those cherries all together in a jar and leave them in their pouches this time around. I'm going to do that a little bit different than I did last time. I also have another blend of Missouri Meerschaum. It's Country Gentleman. And we'll check that out. And we'll see how that is later on in another video. Also ordered another shirt from my father, a Missouri Meerschaum pipe shirt. Corncob pipe shirt. And I'm sure he will enjoy that. So, if I could only get him to smoke a cob now, that'd be a business. Anyhow, I want to show you something that came with the order. This is a book that Pipes and Cigars was giving out. If you spend $100 or more on your order, they would give you this pipe book. It's quite a nice illustrated pipe book. All about the pipe smoking hobby or journey, whatever you want to call it. It's a really cool book. That's kind of neat, isn't it? So you may want to check that out on Pipes and Cigars. Place an order. Spend a little bit of money and get yourself one of those. So with no further ado, we're going to move on to the next box here. The next box is, where else? From Pipes and Cigars. And I'm not kidding you about this tobacco. This stuff is really good. Missouri Meerschaum has really gone out of their way with this. For real. This is some good stuff. So I would highly suggest you checking it out. Giving it a whirl. I mean, the cherry is awesome. It's just not harsh like a lot of the cherries are in these blends. It's in a very, very, very flavorful tobacco indeed. It's just amazing me. Well, as I'm smoking this, I'm like, wow. Now, you know what this is. This is 8 ounces of Dunhill, my mixture. 965. This is awesome. I love this stuff. I got a big mason jar already. got a label on it. I'm just going to jar this right up. Just store it right in my tobacco cellar. And there it goes. There it goes. And then I'm all set for a while with... I've got a pretty decent amount of my mixture 965. So next box is from tobaccopipes.com. I know, it's extra stock. You know me. You know what my favorites are, so here it comes. Indeed. Again, Black House. So, you know, I went ahead and got me a couple more tins of this because Tobacco Pipes restocked, and they like next to never get this stuff, so it's like, you know, there's no shipping involved, so I figured, hey, since they got some more of this in stock, I'm gonna order a couple more tins, and it can't hurt, right? So that's that. And now we got a box here from Famous Smoke Shop. Yeah, I wasn't kidding when I said this was a big yabba, was I? It's quite big. If you look behind me, you can see my new pipe rack that I bought. And I think it stores, let's see, 3, 6, 7 pipes. It's really nice. It's made in Italy. And I will show you that on another video. And it was very, very, very good price for what it was. Okay, what we got here is we got ourselves some the coffee sampler. This is a closeout coffee sampler, and it consists of Tatiana Mocha. You can see through there. Or should I take them out? Oh, okay. And then you want me to take them out and show them to you, right? So, you know, we got Tobacco Special. We got Isla del Sol, a very, very, very top favorite of mine. That's, you know, those two. And then we've got Tatiana Mocha. So I like all of these cigars. They're all primo. They're premium. Or as I know, hand-rolled cigars. And they're good stuff, and I really like them. So, I'm gonna be restocking my humidor with these, so we'll see what we can do with that. So yeah, there you go. That's that, and that is Famous Smoke Shop. If you've never ordered from them, you might want to check them out. It's a nice little catalog here. Or is it a catalog? No, it's not. It's a wine voucher. The amount of wine they want you to order, I cannot use this, so I will not use that. But anyway, I do get the Famous Smoke Shop catalog. And it's an interesting little catalog, so you might want to order... call them and or place an order, and they'll send you a periodic catalog. Now for the mother of the whole box opening. Yep. I ordered a pipe, and I had a hard time finding this pipe. I really did. I saw it around. Okay, this pipe I looked for everywhere. I saw for some pretty high prices. Didn't go for it. Kept searching. It's a Butz Choquin Mirage 1320. First was introduced to this pipe by watching Pip's Pipery Practices. And he was smoking this pipe in his video, and I just fell in love with it. I looked everywhere for it. I had a hard time finding it. I've already actually looked at it. I actually opened the package, so I'm going to do a pipe presentation of this pipe right now, and you're gonna love it. It is a wonderful, beautiful tobacco pipe. It comes in a nice little felt bag, and I kept it in a little plastic bag, but we're gonna pull it right out of both of them. You ready? Forget all that. Look. Look at that beautiful swirl stem. Isn't that nice? Where do you see the finish on this pipe? Look at that. Oh, that is beautiful, man. Beautiful, and also my favorite pipe shape, okay? I know this has been asked in videos many times. Now that is a pipe, okay? That's a classy pipe. The wood grain, it's just, you know, the video just does not do it justice. And this is my first Butz Choquin ever. Or how do you pronounce that? I think the proper way to pronounce it is Butz Choquin. It's French, right? Well, anyway, whatever it is, it's a beautiful pipe. And I'm definitely going to be enjoying smoking this one. I can tell you that. This baby is going to go on my rack right behind me. And I'm putting it on there right now. So there you go. Well, I took off my standwell, and I'll put my standwell back here, and it will enjoy its home over here. I'm sure it won't have a problem. It's all comfortably seated behind me. And that is it for the Abbo. And I am going to finish smoking my Great Dane. You know what? I want to throw a little bonus in here because I want to show you. I ordered a couple Zippo lighters. Besides this one, which I showed you already, that is a fine looking pipe lighter. I love it. Isn't that nice? I love Zippos. I hadn't ordered any for a while. But I'm going to show you a couple others I ordered. This one here, it is another pipe lighter, and it is really nice. You like that? It's called a Fusion pipe lighter. Another one that was kind of hard to get. Nice. I'll tell you what, you can't beat a Zippo, man. That stuff about, you know, tasting lighter fluid, if you fill your Zippo the right way, you run the fuel into it for, and count to six, you'll be fine. You know, you're not going to taste any fluid. And even if you do taste a little fluid, what's the big yada yada about it? You know what I'm saying? Boy, this tobacco is good. This is amazing. It's getting better the further down I smoke it. Now here's just a plain brushed brass Zippo pipe lighter I bought. Kind of like a knock around pipe. And if I want to take the pipe lighter insert out and put it in one of my gold lighters, I can make a matching pipe lighter and go back and forth with that, which I do a lot anyway. I interchange the pipe inserts on these. Now, I think I ordered another pipe lighter too, and I'm going to show you that one. That's back in the drawer back here. Hold on a second. We're going to reach around. Let's see if I can get it out of here. Well, I think you'll like this one. The Rolling Stones. Yep. 1962, made in England, it says. Okay? And that is a pipe lighter, too, by the way. You like that one? It's nice. No fluid yet. But I figured I might as well show them all to you. I will be doing a video coming up soon, very shortly, in the near future, showcasing all of my pipe lighters and my Zippo collection, as well as my pipe collection. And I will be coming up with a contest, because I've already, thanks to you guys, I just have a dedication to make to you guys, man. You guys are great. My train fans, my pipe fans, my cat fans, all you guys, all my YouTube viewers, you guys are, to show my appreciation, I will be coming up with a contest. But I have to mull this over and think about what I'm going to do. But I've hit 2,000. In fact, I'm well over 2,000 now. I think it's 2,020-something last time I checked. So I will come up with some kind of contest. Maybe I'll have one for the train guys and one for the pipe guys. We'll see how that goes. I don't know what I'm going to give out yet. I haven't decided that. Give me a little bit of time, and I will come up with something on that. So that does it for my video tonight. And you've been watching A Great Big Yabo featuring Spaceman and Missouri Meerschaum pipe tobacco. And that's my cat clawing on the door. Yeah, he has OCD. He goes in a litter box and he just keeps coming back and coming back and doing this. And it's like, all right, Moon, enough. Enough OCD for the night. So if you could stay longer, I know you're enjoying my company. I hope. But boy, I'm really enjoying this. This is awesome. This is an awesome pipe tobacco and an awesome cup of coffee, and I'm drinking Don Francisco's Vanilla Nut. So I'm going to jet out of here. And you guys have a good one, and smoke a good pipe and a good blend of tobacco for me. And I'll talk to you later. Cheers.